Collabs are, in the playbook, they're like, hey, we'll do this thing and you can share audiences and you can meet, you know, new people will find your content. That's an amazing way to grow. I generally find that I do that, and then the next video, I feel a lot of pressure because this whole new influx of audience has come in, and then if you make a video and they unsubscribe, you feel very shit. So do you have a plan for what's next? Do you feel that too? Do you...
I've never thought about that before. Good point.
Okay.
I've never thought about that. I don't know.
You never thought about it?
No. I guess a good plan is to just always make stuff you're proud of, you know? I mean, I won't upload a video that I don't like, so... Yeah. Yeah.
I think the key is not to overload with the like-for-like content. So let's just say you did a video where you went to a theme park and it went viral. I think the key is not to then go to, like, all the theme parks in the UK and create the same content. I think you need to vary it and make that new audience fall in love with you, right, and not just that one video.
Yeah,
I just don't think you should oversaturate that one thing.
Do you
disagree?
No. Unless it's like a series on your channel.
Unless
you want that
to become your entire brand. And
right.
If you only do that video and you become that type of YouTuber doing unboxings of that only thing.
Completely agree with that. So I do, like, Christmas time, I do a lot of Christmas unboxing. So that's kind of my thing. So, but what I mean is that in between those videos, I'll put like my vloggy kind of videos and that. So there's other...
Just to show the variety.
Just to show that I'm not just doing one
thing. You're not a one-trick pony.
One-trick pony.
Yeah, it's a good content strategy in general.
Yeah. For example, I collaborated on Marvel a couple years ago. It was so fun. We did prank calls, and it did really well. So I don't do prank calls ever. So what you're saying is I shouldn't do prank calls every single video after that. Because,
But a lot of people do. I've seen newer channels, and they just create the same content, and they wonder why they're not growing. It's because, like... doesn't taper off.
Nice bit of variety. People like variety.
Do you feel like the collaboration, like there's a pressure to collab in order to be a bigger YouTuber or to expand your channel?
That's a really good question. As like a channel that's still developing, I do. I find that pressure all the time. I think I feel like, I don't know about you as well, do you feel that, you know, I should be collaborating more? But I often find it the hardest because sometimes you do reach out to maybe some of a slightly larger audience and they just don't want to collab with you. And it's like, and it is stuff that are, you know, it will be suitable for both channels. But there is a problem, I believe, in the community where there is a lot of collaborators that don't want to collaborate. And it is there. I don't know if it will change as soon as I get bigger. I'm not quite sure. But there is certainly a pressure for developing talent to collaborate and other people not willing to collaborate, unfortunately.
Yeah, and it is the best way to grow, obviously. But there's other ways to, like, some videos can just pop off and you get subscribers from that. Like, I guess, like, following trends when you can help. But there's definitely, like, that pressure. Yeah.
I think the biggest thing, if you can't collaborate, perhaps find something on YouTube that is being searched well. So
right,
use
like a current trend, yes.
Yeah, Google Trends, and then find like the similar videos that are being done, and find that golden piece of content that's not been done before.
Yes, make it your
that's
own.
How I've grown. It's literally finding gaps in the market and just owning it. So go into the meta tags, ranking first.
You're
in the...
smart.
What's a meta tag?
Listen to her.
Sorry.
A meta tag?
A meta tag.
In
your YouTube channel, in your videos. And that's literally, I've grown from strategy rather than collaborating.
I have noticed that when I do get a boost of subscribers, it's from like my own video that got like a good trend or whatever. Yeah, so.
Yeah, I think when I did that strategy, I grew 90,000 in like a month. So,
you're smart.
So I did that strategy and I'm still new to the game. I've only been doing it for like a year and a half. And that's how I grew. And this, I think that takes away from collaborating because I feel like I could do my own thing, enjoy it. And if so-and-so does not want to collaborate with me, then they can, I'm not going to swear.
It's like a saturation point when you've collabed with the same.
Yeah, me and Evan. People.
Who knows?
Right.
Yeah, I don't even know.
I feel like there's a good chemistry between you two.
What's that? Yeah, attention. I feel like
it's chemistry. Really
okay, we live together, so
I'm like third wheeling over here.
Yeah. I shouldn't have sat you next to each other. That's
right. If I make a video with Luke, there's like absolutely 0% growth from either of us.
Yeah.
Because people are like, that fucking ginger kid again.
Do they still get viewed in the same way, though?
I don't really look at it like that. I genuinely just go, I want to make this video with Luke because I think it'd be fun.
But like when I mean, not necessarily in terms of numbers, just in response, is there still an appetite for...
Yeah, I mean, as long as the content's good and it's not just, here's my friend Luke and I laughing over tarot cards and random personality tests for 10 minutes and having actual no content in the video. Like, it's actually something happening.
Yeah, With my sort of strategy towards this is I don't really care about growth.
Yeah.
I don't really care about collabing. So I don't really know why I'm on this panel.
Because I find you attractive. That's
okay,
why.
Thank you. You didn't pick the lineup, but thank
Did
you
not.
Anyway.
I was just trying to make you feel better.
That aside. because you said you feel pressure to collab, to grow. And I don't feel pressure to collab or to grow. I just want to make fun things. And if like
Did you at any point feel that?
Yeah, in the past, right. I definitely did. And I just kind of don't. I don't care. Like, as long as I'm able to pay my rent and as long as people
so what changed
watching
that,
enjoying it, then I don't understand what else matters.
Was there a moment where you went from feeling the pressure to feeling comfortable enough to not worry about growth?
When I stopped growing? No, honestly, I've never really... I say that I felt the pressure to. I felt pressure to. I never bothered doing it.
Right.
Like, I felt like everyone was going, grow, do collabs, do trends. But I've always just gone, nah. So, and it somehow it works, and I'm on this sofa, so cool.
You are. Look at you, there you are.
Thank you.
On that sofa. There.
No, I agree there. I think as you get older in the game, you kind of just don't care about, well, I think collaborating is really important, but I think for your own mental mind, that I think just being happy with the content you're creating yes. completely trumps, like, just collaborating. You shouldn't collaborate for the sake of collaborating just because everyone else is doing it. You should not feel pressured to do it.
I guess that ties back into the chemistry discussion we had earlier on. They can tell.
Yeah, like I collab with my close friends a lot because I like filming with them. I don't do it because it's a collab, but like I like to film with them, how like they talked about. Like I just like filming with my friends. So
that's nice.
Better chemistry works.
I like that too.